For 83 straight years, Notre Dame and Navy have locked horns in a rivalry full of legendary figures. But for 43 years in a row, the luck of the Irish prevailed.
Here come the Irish!
It has to send it in! Good! It is good!
He went out of bounds at the 1.5-yard line. The Irish dodged the bullet.
Dodged it, touchdown! Jay Johnson caught the ball!
It is good! And for the 40th consecutive year, Notre Dame has beaten Navy.
Sharply hands it to Travis Thomas. He'll be stopped, and so will a 43-game losing streak for Navy against Notre Dame. Jones down the middle of the field, catching inside the 20 and running into the end zone. Touchdown, Navy!
Will the Irish revert back to their winning ways? Or is Navy the new captain of the ship? Notre Dame, Navy, next. They are called the Subway Alumni, willing to go anywhere to cheer their beloved Fighting Irish. Navy has its own following, a sea of over 4,000 midshipmen who set sail as one. A sellout crowd of over 80,000 here today at the new Meadowlands Stadium to witness the 84th meeting between Notre Dame and Navy. It's the Home Depot College Football on CBS. And hi, everyone. Craig Bowerjack, glad you're along with us today. You know, Navy has struggled for years against the Fighting Irish, but have won two of their last three. They want more. And moments ago, words of wisdom from Navy head coach Ken Niumatalolo.
9 years ago to this day, 9 years ago, not very far from here, the face of our country and the face of our world changed. And you guys answered the call. I couldn't be more proud or more blessed to be a bunch of brothers like you. Regardless of the course of this game, I love you guys. Let's go have some fun.
Go hard, baby.
Team wins on three, brotherhood on three, all in on three. 1, 2, 3.
Team wins.
1, 2, 3.
Brotherhood.
1, 2, 3.
All in.
Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go.
Randy Cross joins me now. Emotional moments always in a rivalry game such as this. And Randy, you took part in so many.
With all the great tradition of this matchup, you've really got to look at one simple thing. Both these senior classes know that Navy can beat Notre Dame.
It's a big one today. Can Navy knock off the Fighting Irish? Let's find out, because here comes the midshipman of Navy. Notre Dame, Navy, for the 84th time, next on CBS. Welcome back to the new Meadowlands Stadium. The first meeting way back 1927. The Irish won 43 in a row, but Navy has won two of the last three, including last year in South Bend. Weather today, Randy Cross, terrific October afternoon in the Northeast, about 58 degrees, and the forecast is for clear skies. Brian Kelly's in his first year at Notre Dame, replaces Charlie Weiss after a big three-year run at Cincinnati. Still making the adjustment, over 1,000 every Friday for that Irish luncheon, Randy Cross. That's a big hello.
It really is, and the weather's perfect for running or passing. Brian Kelly's got a particular challenge for him. He's going to have to run the ball perhaps a little bit better today. The passing game may be limping around a little.
Well, Notre Dame won the toss. They chose to receive. And so the Irish will be on the field offensively for the first time this afternoon. Notre Dame 4-3 on the year. They have been on a hot streak. They've won three straight against Boston College, Pitt, and last week against Western Michigan And Navy's found a groove. They've won two in a row and both comeback wins against Wake Forest and SMU.
I like this decision, though, by Notre Dame. Take the ball. Don't let Navy potentially grind out a drive and make your way.
John T. kicks it away, and we are underway here. John Goodman sidesteps a tackle to the 26-yard line. Make that Bennett Jackson. So Jackson down to the 26, and the Irish will start first and 10. So the quarterback of Notre Dame is Dane Chris. Now, Randy, a former pocket passer who now runs Brian Kelly's spread offense and is thrown for 14 touchdowns. They will hurry it up all afternoon.
Yeah, they really will. And the most important thing that Dane Chris needs to do is twofold. One, he needs to be able to flip this ball out of his hand very quickly in this Brian Kelly offense. And number two, if need be, he has to be able to run. He's done it effectively the last couple weeks.
41 carries on the season, 4 touchdowns. Running the ball, 14 through the air for Dane Chris, the junior from Canoga Park, California. Here we go. First play, shotgun, handoff. Armando Allen tries to slice his way through a small front of Navy, who's down at the 29-yard line. And for Notre Dame up front, big, no one bigger than left guard senior Chris Stewart at 6'5", 351. And the wide receivers are banged up, including Michael Floyd. Kelly will need a big game from the freshman, T.J. Jones. Second push on the ground, maybe 4 yards up to the 34. And for more on the wide receiver situation, let's check in with Sam Ryan.
And Craig, you see leading receiver Michael Floyd not starting today. I caught up with Coach Kelly moments ago. He told me he doesn't really want to risk anything. He has that sore hamstring. He was out running before the game, some light jogging, but he said the hamstring just isn't 100%. He wants to use him only in emergency situation, guys.
All right, thank you, Sam. You see the numbers on Floyd. Randy, last week, 9 receptions, 157 yards in that win against Western Michigan. Chris, first throw, pitch and catch, right on the button to T.J. Jones. The heart and soul up front for Navy. On the defensive side is left end Jabari Tuwani. And let me tell you, the linebackers can run. Aaron McCauley leads with 50 tackles, a couple of sacks. And Wyatt Middleton is the big hitter in the secondary. Keep an eye on Middleton. Always has played big against Notre Dame. So the Irish move the chains. Mike Ragone, the tight end, goes in motion. Shotgun. Once again, handoff, little stutter step, and a 2 yard, maybe a yard gain to the 43-yard line is Armando Allen.
And if you're used to watching Notre Dame throw the ball all over the lot, look at what they're missing today. And that's Floyd, that's Theo Riddick, who's also out, and Kyle Rudolph, their star tight end, who went out a couple weeks ago with his injury. So it's the better part of their receiving, most of their touchdowns. They've got to be able to run it until they know for sure these young receivers can adjust.
Now, possibly we'll see Floyd if necessary. Let's say it was an emergency situation is what Brian Kelly told us. In the pocket, flushed, goes Chris, has room. Makes a turn at the 50. He's got speed and is bumped out of bounds at the 44-yard line. A pocket passer who has adjusted very well to the spread offense.
And a perfect example of what I was talking about that Dane Chris must do. You break down your integrity on the pass rush. You don't contain him. He does have the tools and the ability to make you pay with the run.
A pickup of 14 yards and another first down at the 44-yard line. Early minutes here. First drive for the Irish. That pocket collapses. Chris flushed once again and is dropped after a 2-yard gain up to around the 41-yard line.
And the reality, Dane Chris is the first one to tell you that this running game for Notre Dame is not what it was. Armando Allen is the last running back to run for over 100 yards last year against Michigan State. They are very much a team that is built to throw it. The offensive line is huge, but not asked to run all the time.
Second down at the 42-yard line. Nearly 3 minutes in on this drive. Play action pass. They set up the screen. Nicely done. Allen on the run has an opening and is knocked down inside the 25 at the 24-yard line. Armando Allen with a sore hip picks up big yards. 17 and another first down, and we've got an injured midshipman down at the 25.
Nice job out in front. Braxton Cave, the center, in the better part of that right side of the line, does a really nice job. Watch the right side from the center over. Block, now run. Get out in front of Allen, throw a block, get on a defender, and give him some room to run. Very nice execution. Dane Crist has ad-libbed a little bit, a couple of runs, and right now that's a beautiful job of executing a screen pass.
We've got Max Blue, one of the inside linebackers, the junior from Carrollton, Texas, down on the turf. Number 44, 41 tackles on the season. That's quite a combination of inside linebackers for Navy. Tyler Simmons one, Max Blue the other. And you're saying inside linebackers, you look at his size, 6-footer, 207-pounder, but you can't weigh the heart, can you?
No, you can't. All these linebackers, look at a guy like McCauley who comes from the other side at the outside linebacker. He's 5'10", 194. They're about speed. They're about precision and discipline.
Eighth play of this drive, Allen out. Sierra Wood is in. Number 20 backs up Allen. He's alongside Chris. Takes the ball, heads near sideline, and is slipped and tackled down at the 19-yard line. Caleb King along with Wyatt Middleton. Notre Dame touchdown drives last week against Western Michigan.
Well, that was a heck of a start to the game. The play to Floyd, 80 yards and a touchdown. A lot of quick strike action out of this offense. Not exactly what you're seeing right now. This is pretty methodical by their standards.
Ninth play of this drive, second down, 20-yard line, and five to go. Handoff straight up the gut. Here comes Wood. Breaks a tackle inside the 10, and Sierra Wood knocked down by McCauley, the outside linebacker, with 50 tackles on the season and a pickup of 11 for Sierra Wood.
Stewart's at 351, Caves at 301 pound. You've got Robinson at about 300 pounds. They've got a distinct weight advantage and they used it.
Chris pulls it down and is stacked up. Good read by Navy at the 7-yard line.
There's a big hit by Wyatt Middleton there at the very end of that run.
Billy Yarborough also in on the tackle, number 90. Defensively for Navy, they allow 163 yards on the ground, but it's tough to get in the end zone. Just about 18 points a ball game allowed this season. Wood lines up alongside Chris. Wants to throw, flushed again from the pocket. Little shovel pass, and he got it off to Wood inside the 5-yard line to the 4.
This is a defense that reacts extremely well, extremely quickly, and the one thing they really like to do under Buddy Green, their defensive coordinator, is they adjust so well. That really speaks to their second half defense and also how they react down here in the red zone, Craig.
Third down and goal, ball at the 4-yard line. Chris has led a very precise opening drive, dancing, pushing, no, Wood. Mark him just shy inside the 1-yard line.
Yeah, you go for it in this circumstance if you're Notre Dame. You've got the size and the strength. You bring in a little bit more of beef, an extra tight end, and a fullback.
I say you go behind Chris Stewart, the left guard. 351, goes 6-5. They pack it tight, keeper.
Don't think so.
Navy waving no. The officials will mark him short, and the midshipman will hold the Irish inside the 1-yard line.
Chris never got a chance. Watch his feet. He can't drive. The Navy defense gets under those great big bodies up in front of him. Chris has nowhere to go. It's nothing but Navy D.
LG, as a proud NCAA corporate partner, presents Game Day Moments.
Go, go Tigers!
Yes!
Go Navy!
Go
Navy!
Go
Navy! Go Navy! Go Navy! Go Navy!
Oh, you gotta love that. 84 straight meeting, longest continuous intersectional rivalry in NCAA. 9 Heisman Trophy winners have played in this rivalry. Notre Dame leading the way with 7.
Well, this is all about pad level and penetration. Look at the blue jerseys. Get underneath the white jerseys. Stop the drive. Sierra Wood tries to get in there and put a little push into his quarterback. But Dane Chris gets on the pile, doesn't move. He's still sort of twisting and turning. You can see where the ball gets to. It's low. His helmet is one thing, but the ball is back by about the 1 yard line. Never gets near the end zone.
A 13 play drive, 71 yards, nearly 6 minutes off the clock, and you give it up inside the 1 yard line. Ricky Dobbs, a quarterback, under center. And they start this drive from the one. Keeper, spinner, and Ricky Dobbs with those magic feet finds his way to the 7 yard line. So Dobbs, a quarterback, offensive line, they're small but very athletic. Average weight up front, Randy, 270. Backs, receivers, Andre Bird, Alexander Teach, and G.G. Green will get most of the work in this triple option.
If indeed Ricky Dobbs' feet are back and that quickness is back, this is the team to do it against.
Teach, the fullback. They hand it right up the gut, and Teach, who last week against SMU had a career high 95 yards. Defensively for Notre Dame, up front, Ethan Johnson leads the way, 3.5 sacks on the year. The linebackers, Manti Te'o, ranks number 5 in the country and tackles 79 stops on the year. In the secondary, how about 3 seniors in that group? Wall, Smith, and Gray.
Ian Williams in the middle, 95 at nose tackle. You better deal with him. He can penetrate.
Third down and short. Breakaway. Teach on the run at the 40, 50. And Teach rumbles inside the 40-yard line. Darren Walls chased him down and saved the touchdown. 54 yards.
Nice drive. Go down, double team, come around, and catch the linebackers. There, it's all about manning and getting Te'o. You put your tackle on Te'o, and he cannot get to the running back. That is just a quick hitter fullback in the triple option offense.
Randy, I mentioned last week a career high 95 yards for Teach. He just ripped off 54.
That's what he does. He runs between A and B quickly.
Fresh downs for Navy. Little pitch out, near side, stutter step, and it cost G.G. Green. Teach with the 2 touchdowns last week, 95 yards, and a terrific second half for Teach and Navy.
Remember, he was originally the starter for Navy. Vince Murray came in, played so well, he couldn't get back in. Murray got dinged. Now it's Teach, and Teach of the two is definitely the quicker type of fullback. He's not necessarily the block reader as much as Murray is, but he will run.
That run of 54, a career long for Alexander Teach. Straight up football, Teach again, 31-yard line. Vince Murray, you mentioned, is out. Left knee sprain. Did not play last week. Out again today. They are talented, though, at the fullback position, and that is where Ricky Dobbs makes his first read. If he gives it and rides the belly of the fullback, off they go. If not, usually then it's Dobbs' decision to keep the ball or do the toss out.
It has to really give the Navy football team a lot of confidence going right at the Notre Dame strength with Williams at nose tackle and Manti Te'o there at inside linebacker. Blocking both those guys and getting the run early on is a big boost.
They're down and 5. Ricky Dobbs sitting back to throw, looking for a screen. The high lob, what a catch. Teach on the run, 15-10. Navy!
Oh, what a play!
What a series by Alexander Teach. A 34-yard reception for 6.
An offense that's been all about methodical and short plays so far this season gets 2 huge plays from their fullback and another perfectly executed screen pass by the Navy offense after Notre Dame did the same.
John Teague in for the injured Joe Buckley. Teague kicks it up and through. 99-yard drive. 6 plays, 3 minutes off the clock.
Starts with a physical challenge to Teague. A bit of a wide throw by Ricky Dobbs, but look at all the blocking down the field. Nothing till Teague gets right to the goal line. Little high, a lot of blocks, crazy crowd. Nice spin and landing.
Alexander Teague catching his breath. Randy, he was a workhorse on that drive. 90 of the 99 yards, Alexander Teach. Dobbs, by the way, throwing his fifth touchdown throw of the season. And Teach on the other end with his second touchdown reception.
This has been a different offense the last 2 weeks against Wake Forest and last week against SMU. The quickness, the fire, and some of the big plays are back.
Teague sent to kick away. Randy, it's a quiet Irish crowd. They pushed the ball so well, stopped inside the 1 yard line. Navy responds with a 99 yard drive to take a 7-0 lead. Teague at the 30, the kicks away. High hanger. Bennett Jackson, 3 yard line. Jackson, near side. Oh, high hurdles! Oh, to the 24!
That was beautiful. Austin Collingsworth, the other returner, gets a nice block in front of him. Goes a little low. Nah, no worries. I'll just jump over it.
It's time now for our Home Depot Tools for Success.
Early on, you're playing against this triple option. You had best stop the fullback. Navy loves to use the fullback, whether it's Murray or Teach, just traditionally in this triple option. That's the first option. You don't stop that, you'll see nothing but. The difference here is Teach is able to bang it in with a nice little catch on a screen pass.
Ready, now the question is, how will Notre Dame respond after moving the ball in fine fashion to start this game? Stopped at the one and gave up a 99-yard drive to the Irish.
I don't expect their heartbeats to be accelerated too much. I think they're going to be very calm. They've got a nice leader in Dane Crist. He'll keep flipping it around and running when they give it to him.
Got this drive at the 24-yard line. Crist, the handoff to Wood. And Wood tries to push the pile. Not much. In fact, maybe got back to the original line of scrimmage. Tyler Simmons, one of the inside backers, with the tackle. Simmons, a big fella, too. For Navy, 6'3", Randy, 237, 240. That's big for Navy standards.
Oh, absolutely. But they are so fast. Don't go sideways. Don't sit in the backfield, jump back and forth. Go right at this defense.
P.J. Jones in motion on the ground. They stay with Wood, and again, cannot run away from the swarm of midshipmen at the 25-yard line. Chase Burge, number 93, and on the initial stop.
Don't go that way. Go that way. This is a defense, we've said it before, not really big, but man, they can run and they are quick. You have the size advantage. Muscle them up and make Buddy Green, their defensive coordinator, scheme and blitz and stunt.
Third down and nine as Chris stands up in that pocket, throws a dart across the middle, right on the button to Tyler Eifert. Let's go down to New York for this John Hancock update. Timmy.
All right, Bowler, number 7 in the BCS standing. That's best ever for Michigan State, but today's their first game outside the state of Michigan. Dan Person takes it in for a touchdown. Back to you, 7-0 score.
Tim, thanks, 7-0 here at the new Meadowlands. Wide open, back-to-back throws, and the hookup is into the arms of Duval Kamara. Now, Kamara is going to have to come up big today with the injury to Floyd. Also, T.J. Jones, the freshman, at the two wideout spots. Don't forget, too, Kyle Rudolph. They're fine, tight end also out. You saw Eifert with the catch, so they're having to do it with a mixed bag. T.J. Jones jumps the pile, and outside he goes, bumped at the 35-yard line by Simmons.
You know, lots of spinning the ball around right now with the throws, but Dane Crist on the last drive, he put a little bug in their ear about how they can run. And then Armando Allen with a nice little screen pass, then the stop on fourth at the goal line.
Jones pitch as he went on the move. The freshman turns the corner, lowers the pads, and boy, he laid out some hurt at the 28-yard line. Gainesville, Georgia, the home for T.J. Jones.
Well, I like that play call by Brian Kelly and his offense right here. That's just an old style in the option, kind of a speed play. Flip it to your receiver coming underneath and use that speed and get a nice block out front for your receivers.
Now you notice, Randy, Notre Dame trying to move the offense a little quicker maybe here on this drive. Crist, pocket, up and over the arms. Is that Toma? Devon Richardson, the free safety who's in for the injured Emmett Merchant, broke up that pass.
Yeah, Kamara and Toma get seeing some different faces with Floyd and Riddick not in there at wide receiver. But the pace is familiar for this offense. And the quicker the better for Brian Kelly. He'd rather, if you saw Oregon Thursday night, he'd rather have that kind of a rapid-fire offense when he gets everybody used to it here.
They line up three wide to the near side on second down and 10. Shotgun, Chris, good protection, flushed, and then stumbles after a yard or two pickup. Burge again on the stop. Burge, a senior from Bushville, Ohio.
And did a nice job on that pass rush. That one was different from the ones you saw Dane Chris run on earlier, because they didn't run themselves out of their pass lanes, and Burge was there to tackle Chris when he got a chance.
Wood lines up alongside Chris. Third down. We call it 10. Shotgun. As we roll up on 3 minutes to play in the first quarter, again, Chris flush from the pocket on the run. Looking. Throws. No flags, incomplete inside the 5 yard line. Quasi Mitchell, terrific coverage on TJ Jones.
This is onside. He decides to throw it up to Jones and see if he and Mitchell can duel and his guy can come down with it. Times it a little bit differently. He maybe comes down with this ball. Dane Chris puts it at the highest point. Pretty clear to see that Jones is the one that gets to the highest point after it, but it gets all the way into his chest and makes the catch impossible.
David Ruffner, 17 straight, made field goal. That ties the longest streak in Division I. On the season, 12 for 12. This will be a 45-yard boot. It's on the way and good. And the streak continues, 18 straight over the last 11 games off the foot of Ruffner. Irish are on the board. Navy leads Notre Dame 7-3. Both these teams have been coasting up and down the field here in the opening quarter. 10 plays, 48 yards, 3 minutes off the clock, and Ruffner with a strong boot of 45 yards. Chris, by the way, Randy, on that drive, 4-6 for 47 yards.
Very important for Notre Dame here. Pin Navy back. Don't give them a chance to start out in great field position. And when you do, shut down the fullback. If you don't, you're going to keep seeing a lot of teach.
Ruffner tees it up at the 30-yard line. 7-3, Navy. A little short. Taken at the 10-yard line. And to the 21. That's where Navy will start this drive. Let's go in downstairs and check in with Sam Ryan.
And Craig, since this game is being played here at the new Meadowlands Stadium, you would think a neutral site location for both teams, right? Well, not exactly for Navy. At the end of yesterday's walkthrough, the coaches and players gathered midfield, and they sprinkled dirt and sand from Iwo Jima and Afghanistan onto the turf here, basically christening it. Now, the latter coming from Steve Looney. The coach is telling me, hey, this is our home turf now.
Sam, thanks. Touching moment, honestly, yesterday as we watched that here at the new Meadowlands Stadium. Gigi Green turns the corner and pushes for a first down. Let's take you back to New York now. Tim Brando with a John Hancock update.
All right, that hurry up is kind of tough. We're going to try this one more time, Bowler. Dan Purse is going to take it in from 3 yards out. Northwestern actually had another chance to score but fumbled at the one. Michigan State's undefeated, but this is their first game off of Michigan soil this year, and they trail 7-0. Back to you.
Timmy B, that person, that offense for Northwestern might be a very well-kept secret in college football. They are tough.
They need that one more win to be bowl eligible. Dobbs will keep it, turns it upfield, little stutter step, and now you know Ricky Dobbs is back. There was a lot of talk, Randy, about Heisman. He was going to run away with it, possibly be one of those outsiders. Injured early in the season, and now you can tell that Dobbs' ankle and knee are healed just the way he cut on that football.
And three perfect illustrations for you out there for the triple option. We've seen the big fullback run. We saw the speed play by G.G. Green on the edge with cut blocks out in front, and that is the second part of the option right there with Ricky Dobbs carrying the ball straight up the field.
11-yard gain, first and 10, midshipmen at their own 46-yard line. There's the fullback read, and stacked up is Teo. Put the helmet on the letters, on the numbers, I should say, of number 39.
Yeah, they're doing a very nice job, Navy is, of getting people and getting blockers on the second level. When you run this option, you literally don't block one of the ends usually, unless he slants in front of the tackle. He doesn't slant, that tackle gets off on the linebacker and for Ken Niumatalolo, he has seen his tackles get on Teo a lot so far.
Aaron Santiago checks in. Green goes in motion. Low pitch. Nicely handled. Has a full steam of ahead of him, and he's popped out of bounds at the 40. I see a helmet on the turf as well. They're hard hitting out there. Harrison Smith and company for the Irish.
Now keep an eye on Teo right there at inside linebacker. It's not a real complicated play, just a quick pitch. He's going to try to flow. When he tries to flow, Navy runs that cut block right there, gets him on the ground. That picks up another body or two, and that buys extra yardage.
Another first down. Anti-Teo.
Boy, you love this kid. What instincts. Great running sideline to sideline ability and strong.
Nose just inside the 39-yard line. Nicely read. That ball is out. And they called it down. Teo was in on that tackle as well. Andre Bird lost the handle, but it was whistled dead at the 41-yard line.
There's Teo lined up there. Watch his reaction. Just perfect. You notice how his shoulders initially never got away from the line of scrimmage. His shoulder pad stayed square as he ran. Almost did a karaoke sideways. Great reaction sideways. The reason you do that is you want to be able to make an adjustment if there's a cutback or deal with a blocker.
Final seconds ticking down here at the new Meadowlands Stadium. Up and down the field we go. And that ends the first quarter. Navy 7, Notre Dame 3. And we'll return to the new Meadowlands Stadium after this message and a word from your local station.
Find complete local info in print at DexKnows.com.
As we start the second quarter, Navy with a 7-3 lead. Craig Bowler, Jack Randy Cross, no penalties, no turnovers. You saw plenty of offense in the first 15 minutes.
And really, for me, the highlight has been Navy's execution blocking-wise. Notre Dame has also countered, but they haven't finished off their drives, where Navy got their chance, and they did finish it off, and their blocking has been extremely crisp. I think Notre Dame's going to have to adjust, start slanting, get in gaps, do things a little differently, because right now Navy's blockers have Notre Dame zeroed in.
You know, Brian Kelly told us as well, they were working on this triple option at summer camp. They knew what was coming.
You know what he'd tell you right now, or tell the, these guys would tell you. It looks a little different live, doesn't it?
G.G. Green in motion, they're going to come in around. Oh, now they're going to throw the ball deep. Little trickery! Pushed down, and flags are everywhere.
It's on Harrison Smith at safety. He grabbed to prevent that catch.
Greg Jones looked like he was coming on the edge, pulled up and threw the long ball.
Notre Dame actually did a nice job.
Pass interference, defense, number 22, 15-yard penalty, first down.
If you look in the backfield, Notre Dame did a good job reacting. They start on the reverse, but then they peel out. Harrison specifically peels out after and just turns around and gets the contact. On the interference, pretty easy to call that one.
Well, Greg Jones, yeah. Throw the flag and we're first and 10 at the 25-yard line. Green, stutter step, tries to turn the corner and reaches out to the 21. Let's go to New York for a John Hancock update. Tim?
All right, Craig, thank you. After last week's loss at Wisconsin to Camp Randall, the Buckeyes trying to rebound at home at the Shoe. Jordan Hall takes it in, and they are thumping Purdue early in the second. It's 21-0. Back to you.
So the Buckeyes having their way with the Boilermakers. Here we got a tight one brewing as we start the second quarter. It's 7-3. Navy and on the move at the 22-yard line. Hear those pads pop as Teach works his way through to the 23. I'll tell you one key, if you're going to play fullback in the option, you've got to have quick feet.
Yeah, you really do. And you've got to have very quick reactions because things happen so quickly. And Ken Niumatalolo's triple option, you're reading that defensive end onside. If he slants, the fullback's not getting. If he doesn't slant, that linebacker's right there.
And we take a look now at the Verizon red zone. Navy's had great success the last three ball games, including this afternoon inside red zone territory. Ricky Dobbs under center at the 18-yard line. He'll tuck and run. Well, he is met head-on at the 15-yard line. Gary Gray made that hit. The senior from Columbia, South Carolina.
Well, they'll make that trade. If you see the linebacker's flow, watch the linebacker Teo onside here flow quickly to his right. That's where the hole opens up. Backside, Calabrese has got to get there to initially stop Dobbs. But by the time Calabrese gets there, Dobbs has got his first down. Quickly can just move those feet, get upfield. Sometimes there's gaps in this defense you don't even know that are there against the option.
Greg Jones, lone receiver, near side. Quick hitter. Here comes Teach. Squares those pads, and, well, he's punishing the Irish here in the first half to the 6-yard line.
The second level is the linebackers. Watch the linemen for Navy get to the second level. Bang, bang. Linebackers across here taken care of. That gives Teach a great opportunity. Tail can just get a fraction of an arm because of a nice block by Santiago coming from that S-back position.
Teach last week, 95 yards on the ground already here in the first half. 6 carries for 74. And this is the 10th play of this drive. Teach trying to push a big pile to the 4-yard line. Ethan Johnson and company team up to stop Teach. Conroe, Texas is home.
We're going to measure here. His running game so far, too, also inside it, bears mentioning, is doing a nice job dealing with big Ian Williams, 305-pound nose tackle.
Now they're going to stretch the chains. And first down. It'll be goal to goal inside the 5-yard line. You know, Randy, a lot of talk about size, and Navy deals with it week after week after week, and they counter the big size of their opponent with quickness and technique.
It's technique, it's also precision. They run the same place over, over, over again.
First and goal as Dot goes under center. Keeper, spinner, up to the 3-yard line. Calabrese with the hit, number 44, inside linebacker. And Randy, look at the red zone inefficiency, but until the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, then the last 2 weeks, Wake Forest 4-for-4, including the big game winner late. The pass from Ricky Dobbs to Jones last week against SMU, coming back and blasting them the way they did in the second half, offensively playing so well. And early on here, Ken Niumatalolo's offense has gotten their opportunities. And like we said earlier, they have been the ones that have finished off the opportunity. It's key, too, when you get into this red zone, penetrating further. When a guy like Buckley, your regular kicker, is hurt and out, you'll have the backup who doesn't have the range.
Timeout, Navy. 11:07 to play. First half. We'll be back. Make sure you watch Fantasy Football today to get the last minute news and analysis you need to set your Fantasy League lineup. It's live every Sunday, 11 a.m. Eastern, and it's only on CBSSports.com. Here we are with 11 minutes to play in the first half. Randy Cross, it's amazing. Navy has been able to go up and down the field. Notre Dame has well, but only gotten 3 points out of it so far.
Well, they've done it with a very clean efficiency, blocking-wise, getting after the Notre Dame defense, getting linebackers and running backs free on, or getting a lineman and running backs free on the inside linebackers. That's really been the key.
You like Dobbs on this play?
If you let the fullback beat you right now, you're nuts.
Under center goes Dobbs. Turns, cuts. At the goal line. Touchdown, Ricky Dobbs.
This Notre Dame defense has to get on the sideline right now. Get out the grease board, get out the pictures, and they have to come to some consensus about what they're looking at, because there are some huge gaps inside of this defense.
Another rushing touchdown for Dobbs. Teague up and through the uprights. and Navy has opened up a 14-3 lead. Dobbs quick, stacked up, pushes into the end zone for six. Ricky Dobbs, 41 career rushing touchdowns. And Navy on top. The Home Depot College Football on CBS will continue after this word from your local station. Well, the first drive went 99 yards. This one goes 77. 12 plays, 7 minutes off the clock, and Dobbs turns it up and in for a touchdown. And it's 14-3, Navy over Notre Dame.
As we suggested, that Notre Dame defense over there hard at work. Their coordinator, Coach Diaco, is upstairs, I'm sure, letting everybody know down there what he thinks. But it's really been pretty simple. The Notre Dame defense right now, especially inside, is just flat getting blocked.
Teague has it teed at the 30-yard line. And the kick is away. High, high hanger. A little bit short. Bennett Jackson on the run straight up the middle. Weaves his way to the 28-yard line. So Christ and company will go back to work. Down 14-3 here on CBS.
At the Meadowlands, Navy leading Notre Dame 14-3, and this Navy team finding inspiration from a young fan. 13-year-old Sean Squires is from New Jersey. He suffers from cystic fibrosis, where every day can be a challenge. Recently, he was invited to attend Navy practice. The players even took him into the locker room, leaving a lasting impression. Now, Coach Ken Niumatalolo told me it's the little things that may touch a kid or a fan that means a lot to him. Sean, at today's game, as you can see, his father told me Navy is 10-0 at games he's attended, guys.
Thank you, Sam. Inspirational story. And right now, well, it's a 14-3 lead. This guy may be the lucky charm for the midshipman. Chris goes back to work, flings it out to Allen. He's on a sore hip, and he works his way to the 35-yard line. And Hauberger, the outside linebacker, number 31, in on the stop. We didn't see Allen for a while. Sierra Wood got some carries. Allen just maybe to try to work him in, try to save him a little bit with that sore hip.
Well, if there's one thing that Brian Kelly doesn't have offensively and defensively like he wants here so far at Notre Dame, it's the speed and the pop.
In this direction, Armando Allen spinning, first down, 41-yard line. Chase Burge, who's had a busy first half with another stop for Navy.
Well, there's more of the point A to point B kind of a running game, not going sideways, just little delayed smack up inside, but Allen just going straight ahead instead of trying to dance sideways.
Saw Brian Kelly and company throwing in the offensive plays to Chris, this time shotgun. Handoff, Allen, left side, spins and picks up 3 hard yards. Simmons, Tyler Simmons, inside linebacker with some help from his teammates.
This Navy defense is really, like we said, they are quick. They've got a guy inside it with Jabari Tuwani. Played last week, one play without a helmet, got smacked around a little bit, but
5 wide receivers set, this time a sliding grab by Kamara. Jersey City, New Jersey, here's that play you spoke of last week. Tuwani won the hearts and souls of his teammate.
And his defensive coordinator, Buddy Green, when we asked him about that, just basically said, you know what, that's kind of who we are.
Boy, did he take a shot on the chin.
And he was back, by the way, a few plays later on when they needed him.
Chris, nice cutback. Allen up the gut, breaks another tackle inside the 40 to the 38-yard line. Kevin Edwards wrapped him up.
This is just point A to point B, and you're getting a nice running lane. Look at that. It would be right over the right shoulder of the right guard. Beautiful reaction. Nice job by Cave, 52, the center. Leading everything in that direction, and a good read.
Pick up a 12, play action pass. Chris stepped up in the pocket under pressure. That ball hangs and knocked down inside the 5-yard line. Chris threw into double coverage, and Billy Yarborough, credit him for bringing the heat. on Dane Chris.
Well, Chris got the ball off fine, but he had to hear Billy Yarborough coming. You can hear the breathing. You can feel the presence. And just doesn't have quite the distance. See the little wobble on that ball? Here's why the ball wobbled. He's getting ready to get hit more than he's stepping into the throw.
Three wideouts top of your screen. Keeper, Christ, and by the jersey, Burge pulls down Christ. Nearly took the shirt off his back at the 31-yard line.
It's a little read option kind of back at you by Notre Dame, letting their quarterback run inside.
Well, they really stretch the field. Five wides. Notre Dame 3 of 5 this afternoon on third down. They need 3 yards to keep this drive alive. This sets up, throws a tough pass across the field, and Goodman with the catch. They're going to mark his forward progress, I believe, past the first down marker at the 27-yard line.
It's the one thing about this Notre Dame offense, if you are Navy, you have to be resigned to the fact that with Dane Chris arm, he's going to flat get the ball in spots where you can't stop the completion. But Buddy Green, the defensive coordinator, made a point that we got to tackle them once they get that ball.
Yeah, fresh down to the 27. Shotgun, Chris, play action, rolls out, looks, doesn't pull the trigger. Now he's running for his life. Oh, steps out of trouble and picks up about 8 to the 21-yard line. Simmons and Burge finally run him down.
Nice coverage down the field. There is nowhere for Dane Chris to go here on the top side. See all those spots. He looks. Everyone's covered. Everything downfield covered. Go ahead and run it. You know, and Chris is showing the last 3 weeks. He's not running for his life as much as it's taking advantage of defenses, Greg.
Second down. Call it 5. Throws a dart. Far sideline. Nice grab. Taken down at the 11-yard line. Duval, Kamara. The heat's on these wide receivers because of injuries to Floyd and also to Theo Riddick. And so far, the young guys have come up big.
And remember, Kamara specifically, he came to Notre Dame to play for Charlie Weiss in that pro-style offense. Brian Kelly's offense isn't exactly that same kind of offense, but right now, the kid's doing a nice job of adjusting.
11th play of this drive. Irish are trying to tell Navy right back at you, but this time, the midshipmen stand up and knock down Chris Tuwani. I think he likes to play better with a helmet, but...
Well, you're making that read, and when you see the defensive tackle slant down, that should be the read coming right at you. Maybe you don't want to be holding the ball when he gets there.
Let's take a look at the Verizon red zone, and the Irish knocking on the door at the 16-yard line. Second down. Christ in the pocket, throws, ball tipped and complete. Pressure on Christ.
Oh, yeah. Watch McCauley, the outside linebacker. 29. We talked about him being 5'10", 5'11", 194. Not very big, but, man, can he come screaming around the corner. And he's the reason Chris couldn't step into that throw, and it went wobbling.
Billy Yarborough tipped that ball. The pressure from the corner, as you mentioned, McCauley. And now a big third down. Armando Allen checks back in. Need 14 for a first down. Christ in the pocket. Pressure, throws, fires. On his feet. Touchdown, T.J. Jones! Terrific second effort by the freshman.
Perfect example, too, if you give a quarterback like Dane Christ a little bit of time, let him survey your defense. He is going to stroke one in there accurately and make you pay.
Ruffner set to try the point after. A 16-yard strike from Chris to T.J. Jones, his third touchdown reception of the season. And the Irish answer back, down 14-3. They cut it to 4. Chris, good patience in the pocket. And how about the second effort by the freshman? T.J. Jones from Gainesville, Georgia, makes his third touchdown reception of the season. And Chris likes what he sees. 14-10, Navy.
Tim Brando in New York. Coming up on the Geico Halftime Report, Spencer and I will get you caught up on all of the action, including Ryan Mallett returning from that concussion last week. Threw a pick on his first pass of the day, but here a beautiful catch by Greg Childs. 14-0, they lead Ole Miss. Now back to Notre Dame and Navy.
All right, thank you, Tim. The Hogs up by 14. Here it's 14-10, and the scoring drive is like Navy. Notre Dame put together, Randy, a 13-play drive, 72 yards in just under 5 minutes off the clock.
And a great answer, and a specifically an excellent answer by Dane Chris. Look at the matchup he got. He got his receiver, Jones, against a linebacker, McCollum. Now, not a big linebacker, but still a linebacker nonetheless. You get a slot receiver on that linebacker, you should beat him just like that, and you should score.
Chris on the phone after that impressive drive to cut Navy's lead down to 4. 6 minutes to play here in the first half. Ruffner set the kick from the 30-yard line. Teed up. Good ball game here at the New Meadowlands Stadium. Underneath, Statton at the 20. Stacked up, dropped, and still on his feet. Picks up a couple of yards on second effort to the 26-yard line. Wednesday on CBS, when the prosecution fights dirty, the defenders fight right back. Jim Belushi and Jerry O'Connell star. That's Wednesday right here on CBS.
Let's see if any of those adjustments the Notre Dame defense made on the sideline to this triple option pay any quick fruit.
You like offense? How about 5 possessions, 4 scoring drives, and the one drive we didn't see a score was ended at the 1-yard line. Dobbs starts at the 27-yard line. On the keeper. Still on his feet. Oh, stumbles, and or he would have had a big gainer at the 36-yard line. Let's get an update. Let's go back to New York, and here's Tim.
All right, Craig, you know, the Cyclones of Iowa State have never beaten Texas in 7 prior meetings. Here, Alexander Robinson on the option takes it in from a yard out. Look out. Iowa State leading Texas in Austin 14-3. Back to you.
All right, Tim, thanks. Iowa State 0-7 all time against the Horns. Got a good one here. The Meadowlands, the new Meadowlands Stadium, pitched to the side. G.G. Green tiptoes down the sideline. They mark him out of bounds right at midfield. Call up the 49-yard line. Gary Gray with the tackle.
This is exactly what a triple option will do. Fullback, quarterback's not going to take it. He's going to flip it to the halfback. Look at all that green grass on the outside. It'll make you talk to yourself. I don't care if you're a defensive coach or a defensive player. If you don't have it going on and dialed in, you will mutter yourself.
You know what? And Dobbs has to have such great chemistry with his slot backs, because that ball hangs out there for a while, and it's all about timing. You've got to be on the same page. First and 10 at the 49. Dobbs is going to pitch. Did you see the hesitation? He turned it up, and it was knocked down to the 50-yard line by Teo. Wednesday on Survivor, playing tricks and trash talking are just part of the game. But do these players have the strategy to go on and win it? Don't miss a new Survivor. It's on Wednesday night right here on CBS. Look at those possessions. I mean, you chew up clock, you chew up yards.
And that's one of the things you know when you play Navy. Unless your defense has an all-star day, you are only going to have a limited number of possessions against this triple option.
Second down at midfield. Backside pressure. Dobbs with a look and then pushes past the 45-yard line. Calabrese and Fleming in on the tackle. Dobbs gave it a glance and then tucked and pushed it upfield.
Well, he's got more of a feel than anything else to space inside the way it looks. And Teo, number 5, and Calabrese, number 44, the inside linebackers, they've got to be tied to his hip. No matter where he goes, they've got to be responsible for that quarterback.
Maybe 3 for 3 today on third down conversions. They need about 5 to keep this drive alive. Ricky Dobbs will lose 2. Ethan Johnson broke through to make the tackle.
Well, you can worry about scheme, or you can do what Ethan Johnson does on this play. Coming from that end position, they're reading that defensive end, and Ricky Dobbs never gets to read him. He needs to greet him, or gets to greet him. Nice job just smothering that thing.
Fourth down. And now the question is, they're going to let this clock run and chew some time. We're under 3 minutes, Randy Cross, in this first half. I wouldn't think that you'd want Ruffner with a chance for Notre Dame to boot one through in the final half minute of this first half.
No, ideally you wouldn't, but one way or the other, you got to put the ball back in Dane Chris' hands, and that's where it leads you.
Greg Buller, Jack Randy Cross, Sam Ryan, our CBS crew back here at the new Meadowlands Stadium. And my point, Randy, I didn't think that Niumatalolo was going to go for it on fourth. I was looking for Della Hook, and there he is after the timeout. They want to try to push the Irish as far back as they can in the final 2:45. Della Hook looking for a pooch kick. Nice high hanger. Goodman lets it take the bounce at the 2-yard line. That's how you do it.
That was a smart decision by Goodwin, and it was a beautiful kick by Della Hook.
44-yard punt coming up on the Geico Halftime Report. Tim Brando, Spencer Tillman will be by with all the scores and all the highlights, plus a preview of the SEC showdown between 6th-ranked LSU, 4th-ranked Auburn. That's coming up on the Geico Halftime Report. For the SEC, each and every week, you got yourself a barn burner.
It seems like every week there's at least one top 10 matchup.
Notre Dame starts his drive inside the 5. Ball batted down to the line of scrimmage. And Billy Yarborough has been an active right end for Navy's front line this afternoon.
The senior, Billy Yarborough, has declared Marine ground as his choice after graduation. Doing a nice job on the air right here with Dane Chris. Gets those hands up, bats it down. And if you're Notre Dame, you do not want to make a mistake with the football here. We've got plenty of time and 3 timeouts.
Second down, inside the 5, Chris the keeper. That was a design play from the start, and he picks up a couple to the 7. Max Blue, who was shaken up earlier in the ball game, in on the tackle. You look at the first 3 possessions for the Irish, you give it up at the 1-yard line on downs. You come back with a field goal and then a touchdown to make it 14-10 with just over 2 minutes to play.
And you play this offense, that's really when it's moving, this triple option. You've got to get quality and points out of those possessions in the red zone.
Chris down to roll out, wobbler, midfield, intercepted at the 30-yard line, Devon Richardson. That ball was looked to be deflected to the line of scrimmage and just floated into the hands of Navy.
Well, I'll be interested to see if it is deflected, because Jones is the nearest receiver, and it almost looked like Dane Chris was expecting him just to curl up there and come back towards him. He keeps running through the defense, and when he does that, there's no one there to catch the ball outside of Devon Richardson.
That was a wobbler thrown by Chris, his 6th interception of the season, and the first pick by Devon Richardson.
That's exactly what you don't want to do when you're backed up as an offense.
Avery back to the ground. They're going to give it to Teach, who grinds it to the 25-yard line. Under 2 minutes to play in this first half. Now let's set up the timeouts. 1 remains for the midshipmen. Notre Dame with 3.
I would think Navy would be perfectly happy just taking their pace, running their plays, trying to penetrate as far as possible, perhaps taking a shot with a pass, but generally speaking, be happy if they get a field goal out of this possession.
Second down at the 26-yard line. Dobbs under center. He'll keep it. Up the gut he goes, and a first down. They're going to mark him past the 20 to the 19-yard line. Ethan Johnson with the stop. Now remember, Joe Buckley's out with that knee injury suffered last week. They're field goal and PAT kicker and John Teague. So they want to push it as close as possible to give him a shot before halftime.
That was going to be about a 20-30-yard run if Johnson doesn't grab Ricky Dobbs by the shoelaces there and bring him down.
1 minute to play. G.G. Green in motion. Dobbs, keeper. Up to the 11-yard line. Kerry Neal with the tackle for the Irish.
See, this is sort of the method to the madness for Navy from the standpoint of not calling timeouts, of just running the plays, knowing what you have, specifically inside, Craig. Because inside has been where they've been the most effective
34 seconds and counting. Up the gut, inside the 10. Now that could stop the clock if they want to set the chain, but the clock does run. Now they stop it with 25 seconds remaining. This is close. And they're going to have the chain gang on the field. One timeout for Navy with 25 seconds to play. They're trying to add to their 14-10 lead.
And for some football fans, this might be handling the clock this way. It might be a little counterintuitive. But for Navy in this style of offense, I think this is exactly what they need to do. When they have a kicker the way they have with Buckley hurt and teeing in, Teague's more of a pop-up kind of a kicker. He doesn't kick the ball very far.
And there's nobody getting a warm-up kick. John Teague is, and Kenny Amatalolo thinking maybe we're going in for six. First and goal inside the 10-yard line pitch. G.G. Green, oh, what a stiff arm. The five.
If he didn't step out of bounds, that is incredible. That stiff arm on Calabrese.
I just saw the hands go up. They wanted to take a look. I'm guessing it's going to be reviewed, but the stiff arm broke him open.
Well, the stiff arm was beautiful. And then how about the, hey, you want to see a little Reggie Bush at USC? Remember the move he was signature for, the reach out? Wow. What a beautiful run. Nice execution. You're right. Why warm up when you're going to score a touchdown? That was clean, though. Craig, if you study the sideline here, quick straight arm, leap, take off, ball crosses, and he's still in the air.
Now they're showing it on the replay screens here at the stadium, and I think the crowd agrees that G.G. Green. How about the left hand? Let's see what the left hand tells you. Is he out?
Over. No, before that left hand gets down, that ball has already gone past the goal line.
That's a great blow up.
Did not step out of bounds before crossing the goal line. Touchdown.
That's Dennis Hennigan from the Big East, the referee. And so the touchdown stands. G.G. Green rumbles in for his second score of the season. And now John Teague will try to chip in the extra point. Navy last week, Randy Cross shut out in the first half against SMU. They came back with 28 points to win it in a thriller in Annapolis. G.G. Green, in he goes. And Niamatalolo with a fist pump. The interception by Crist proves costly. Quick hit offense, five plays, 30 yards. And G.G. Green stiff arms his way in for a 9-yard touchdown.
Well, he stiff arms with that right hand on Calabrese, gets to the sideline, switches the ball over to the right hand, and it's with that same right hand, he reaches out and scores a touchdown.
14 seconds of play before we break for halftime. Navy's open up a 21-10 lead on Notre Dame. Teague the catch, kick the high hanger, Jackson at the five. But that the 20s. Out of tackle, sit on his feet. Stops and goes, and he'll lose a couple of yards on second effort back to the 18-yard line. Well, Thursday on CBS, everybody knows you never hit on your friend's sister. But what happens when your friend's sister hits on you? A new Big Bang Theory, Thursday, only on CBS. And now Chris is just going to let the clock run. He'll take a snap, hit a knee, and the first half winds down here, Randy Cross, at the new Meadowlands Stadium. And what a performance by Navy in the first half.
I'd like to be a fly on the wall in that locker room for Notre Dame.
Let's take you downstairs. Here's Sam Ryan.
Well, Coach Ken, you have the momentum going into the half. You got the touchdown off the interception. What do you tell them to keep the intensity up?
Football's not played in halves. You know, the game's still going. We still got a half to go. That's a great football team. They got explosive offense. We got a long ways to go.
Ricky looking like the Ricky of old, looking healthy today. The ability to move the ball. What's clicking today?
Well, he's playing well. He's being smart with the football. But like I said, you know, that's just one half. Hopefully we can finish.
Thanks a lot, Ken. Craig.
All right. Thank you, Sam. That ends the first half. The score, Navy 21, the Irish 10. We take you now to Tim Brando in our New York studio. Navy leads the Irish 21-10, just moments away from the start of the third quarter. Let's go downstairs. Sam Ryan with Notre Dame head coach Brian Kelly. Sam?
Okay, Craig and Brian, they have 186 yards on the ground. What do you guys need to do defensively to stop their option?
Well, they're running Veer, which is a scheme that obviously they've held back. We've made the adjustments at halftime. Again, we've got to get off some blocks. You know, they're getting us on the ground. All the things that a good option offense does, nothing unexpected there. But they did feature the Veer, which is something that they haven't used. So we've made those adjustments. And then if we just, you know, put the ball in the end zone, you know, on fourth and goal, and not throw a silly pick, you know, right before the half, you know, we're in good shape. Now we got to battle back in the second half and play flawlessly.
Thanks a lot, Brian. Yeah. Craig.
All right, thank you, Sam. Thank you, Coach. Craig Buller, Jack, Randy Cross. Interesting points. First, you do give up 7 when you're stopped at the 1-yard line on your first drive, and then the late pick by Chris turns into a touchdown for Navy.
I've got a really even simpler formula for Coach Kelly. Your guys got to get unblocked. They've been blocked like crazy. I don't care if it was the wishbone, the Veer, the triple option. They've blocked them so, so well, and the stats really reflect that.
Yeah, the numbers prove out just how effective Navy's ground game has been. Randy, if you put a calculator to it, we're talking nearly 7 yards a carry on the ground in the first half for the midshipmen.
And they've had their way about any way they want to do it, inside, outside. Ricky Dobbs after the fake using the follow. The surprising side has been the inside of the Notre Dame defense. That's the main adjustment I want to see. Linebackers, Calabrese, nose tackle. Williams and Tail, the other inside linebacker. How is that adjustment in there going to be made?
Here we go, Irish! Let's go,
Andy! Navy will have the football to start the second half with the 21-10 lead. Ruffner set to kick it away.
That's the great thing about making adjustments at halftime. If you're Notre Dame here, you get to use them right away.
And we're set to go. High hanger. Statton at the 10. At the 20, right up the middle he goes and is tackled at the 22-yard line.
Pretty good variety when it comes to the touchdowns for Navy. A little quick flip and a screen pass to Teach for the first one. What a beautiful run and finish by Teach. Then Ricky Dobbs takes it in himself. On the second, and the third is a straight arm, an arm switch, and a dive by G.G. Green for 7 points.
Yeah, Green with 6 carries, 52 yards. Teach, 9 carries, 84. Dobbs, 11 carries for 52 yards. They spread the wealth around. The Navy's on. That's exactly what they do. And they're going to start this second half on the ground with the fullback, Teach, who pulls a couple of Irishmen down to the 35-yard line. Harrison Smith, the safety, with the tackle.
Nice job of creating a crease right here off the wingback. Watch the execution on the blocks. Tight end down, guard around, quick little trap. Nice alley inside against this Notre Dame defense. They gave him a little bit of a different look. They hadn't showed that in the first half either, so Navy obviously had a couple adjustments too.
95 yards last week for Teach, already with 96. He is flirting with 100 on the ground and fresh down to the 35-yard line. Teach, he's right at 100 to the 38-yard line. Capron Lewis-Moore with the stop. You look at the first half possessions. You start on your own one. You go 99 yards. That was a statement drive to start this ball game after making the defensive stop on the Irish.
And even the lone non-scoring drive for Navy with the punt set up the following touchdown. Because that's when Chris got backed up. Notre Dame got backed up. They made that mistake and threw that interception.
So far, it's been a fullback drive. Dobbs with the keeper, turns it upfield. One tackle over the break, and he ran right through the arms of Mata, and Teo was there as well for Notre Dame.
How could you not run the ball if you're Ricky Dobbs right there? Because once he pulled that ball out of the fullback's stomach and he looked left, there was nobody there. They were just begging him to run the ball up the field. So far, not real impressive adjustments out of this Notre Dame defense. It's a matter of execution. The nose tackle's got to hold his ground, and everybody's got to play assignment football against this option. You start freelancing, you're toast.
Andre Bird checks in. First and 10, fullback keeper inside the 50 to the 49-yard line. And what do you say we meet Ricky Dobbs?
Ricky Dobbs, hometown, Douglasville, Georgia. My service selection is surface warfare. What has surprised me most about the Naval Academy is all the family tradition here. In high school, I dreamed of being president of the United States. My favorite Coach Neil Montalolo saying is, working hard only gives us a chance, man.
There's Ricky Dobbs, quarterback of Navy. He's thinking White House. One day, with a pitch nicely read by the Irish. Maybe that's the adjustment that Coach Kelly spoke of. Manti Te'o staying home. Nice tackle.
Well, we've seen Te'o a few times today early on make these kind of reads and reactions. That's natural, instinctive out of the inside linebacker for Notre Dame. Look at the job he does of sliding, adjusting, and then just zeroing in on the runner, running back. Beautiful linebacker play there by Te'o.
6'2", 245. Well, he can go sideline to sideline. Came in as the fifth raked tackler in Division I football. Dobbs pedals back and wants to throw the ball. He's got a man open. Got him over the shoulder. Greg Jones looked inside out.
I wonder if any time Greg Jones was tempted to almost fair catch this ball. It hung so long, it was almost like a punt. From the end zone will be a perfect view. Ricky Dobbs isn't too pressured, steps into it, flips it up there, ball hangs and hangs, and Jones makes two or three adjustments before the final adjustment for the catch.
Oh, Ricky Dobbs trots down, fresh set of downs, first and goal at the 9-yard line. Dobbs, the keeper, cuts back inside, jumps over the middle, touchdown! Ricky Dobbs!
You can match schemes all you want. You can adjust all you want. Right now, Notre Dame cannot match the intensity or the execution of Navy, but especially the intensity. They're playing with a whole different level of emotion.
Just when you think you're going to run, then you have to respect the arm of Dobbs. We talked to Brian Kelly about that exact fact this week. Teague to kick the extra point and splits the uprights. 42 career rushing touchdowns. That's the second most, just one behind Chris McCoy. So quick, so strong as Ricky Dobbs rumbles in and Navy starts the second half. Impressive drive and they get seven. 28-10. I'm trailing here at the New Meadowlands Stadium on CBS. Seven plays, 77 yards, 3:37 off the clock. Opening drive of the second half, and Dobbs caps it off with a 9-yard run. A key play, Randy, on that drive was a 40-yard pass. And again, it's the Irish trying to make the adjustment, but what happens is Ricky with the arm can still keep you off balance.
Watch Johnson, the defensive end, coming from this side. His reaction, he closes with the tackle, right? Then he decides to run back out, but when he runs back out, Ricky Dobbs runs back in, and look at the hole that's created by that stretch. There is nothing at all outside of a linebacker on his back. So if you needed any proof that Dobbs could still cut and that ankle was back, then you just got a pretty good one here on this artificial surface.
I think that's what the conversation is on that Irish bench with the defensive front. Boy, so tough just to play at home, isn't it? Because of the movement of that offense of Navy.
If that's your assignment, stay there because somebody's supposed to fill behind you.
Jackson on the move, breaks the tackle, but stood up and dropped at the 22-yard line. Navy is fired up, and tomorrow the NFL on CBS rolls out doubleheader games. First, Big Ben and the Steelers take on Brandon Marshall and the Dolphins, and then Tom Brady and the Patriots against Philip Rivers and the San Diego Chargers. It all starts with the NFL today with Shannon Sharp. He'll also take an in-depth look at the Cincinnati Bengals. NFL Today, tomorrow. on CBS.
Yeah, the Bengals picked by a lot of teams to be right there as one of the better teams in the league have really sputtered to be nice.
Notre Dame needs to answer. Chris throws. It's underneath. The T.J. Jones has room. Still on his feet and taken down at the 40-yard line. So a pickup of 15. You know, Brian Kelly told us straight up, listen, with the injuries to our wide receiving core, this young man, T.J. Jones, needs to play big on Saturday afternoon. First down, 41. On the ground, Armando Allen. And a nice chunk up to about the 48. Call that a 7. Well, Floyd's out with the hamstring. Now, we were told in an emergency, Floyd may see action. Are you blowing the horn right now, Randy?
No.
Is this an emergency at 28-10?
No, I don't think so. This is an offense that can strike quickly. And what, you bring him in, he pops a hammy, you don't have him the rest of the year or maybe for a month?
Allen, big hole right side. Thrown down at the 44-yard line by Tyler Simmons. Last week, Floyd was dynamite. 9 catches, 157 yards, and 3 touchdowns. But the hamstring is tight.
Yeah, highlighted by that very first play of the game, 80 yards against Western Michigan for the touchdown. But the guys in there have to do it. And with this quarterback, Dane Chris, they can do it.
Chris play action. Throws, got man coverage. Oh, coming over the top was Wyatt Middleton. Out of bounds, the call. Where did Wyatt come from?
Well, he came from deep middle. That throw is supposed to be fit right in over the top of the corner in front of the safety. Just too much air. That gives Wyatt Middleton that time to react over the top. And he steps down on the white paint, stepping out of bounds.
You know, as a freshman, he had 14 tackles against Notre Dame in that triple overtime thriller last year, 8 tackles. Something about Notre Dame and Wyatt Middleton, huh?
These Navy players know how to react against these big opponents.
Second down from the 45-yard line. Chris, shotgun throw. That was telegraphed. And the pick by Mitchell. 2 interceptions thrown by Dane Chris. And Navy, with a 28-10 lead, will get the ball right back.
A very important part of this game is emotion. The emotion is all on Navy's side. I said at the beginning of the game, these seniors know how to beat Notre Dame. These Navy seniors right now are beating Notre Dame.
The Home Depot College Football on CBS is sponsored by Aflac, Verizon, Chick-fil-A, and by New York Life Insurance. Well, another Navy win over Notre Dame is brewing here at the new Meadowlands Stadium. And there's the interception. The second thrown this afternoon for Christ.
Like you said, at that very moment, it was telegraphed. You knew where that ball was going. And you've heard of the front shoulder throw. That was the back shoulder. That was the front shoulder. There was never a doubt. There's also no doubt in Dane Chris' mind what his head coach Brian Kelly thought of that pass.
Well, since that touchdown toss to Jones, Chris now 1 of 5, 17 yards and 2 interceptions. And now Navy with the football under 10 minutes to play third quarter, and it's a 28-10 ball game.
Navy changes up their zones just enough under Buddy Green that you can think you know what you see, but what you really are getting is something different.
Dobbs under center, running the option to perfection. And a push up to the 30-yard line by Teach. Let's take you to New York for the John Hancock update. Here's Tim.
All right, fellas, a classic Big Ten strong formation left here for Michigan State, and they go opposite off the play action fake. It's Benny Fowler, 22 yards to make it 17-14. The Spartans back in it with 10 and change remaining in the third. Back to you.
All right, thank you, Tim. I think Brando likes to call them the Sparties, by the way, but the Spartans making a comeback.
Coach D'Antonio and his football team, very tough, very physical, right now getting outplayed.
Quick hitter, Teach. To the push from the fullback spot, whether it's Vince Murray or Alexander Teach, even Delvin Diggs, number 37, who gets a few looks on occasion. That push from that position is so important.
Well, and that's why we talk a lot about emotion in this game. And emotion sometimes takes the parter takes the embodiment of that kind of push. It's those offensive linemen, especially the inside three for Navy, that are setting this whole offense up with the holes they're blasting inside on this Notre Dame defense.
Navy third down and three. They are 4 of 5 on third down conversions in this ballgame. Come to the near sideline. Teach has the first down and more. Well, the fullback shows speed to the 45-yard line, chased down by the safety Harrison Smith.
Now, that's why on occasion you've seen Teach actually return kicks. Watch him put his foot in the ground. Nice blocking up front, a little bit of a different look. But look at him jam that left foot in, and when he jams it in, he is gone to the outside. That is all instinct. Blocking was okay inside. He just saw nobody outside and a chance to pop it out there and get some extra yards.
You know, we had an Irishman down, Harrison Smith, along that Navy sideline. The midshipman tried to give him a hand. He pops up, and now he makes his way to the sideline. That right arm is hanging very loosely. Harrison Smith out of Knoxville, Tennessee, a senior. Clock running up on 8 minutes to play third quarter. Dobbs, big hit. Teach on the run, rumbling past the 35 to the 29-yard line. Teach is cutting his way through Notre Dame's defense.
Just carving. You're blocking down, and then you're bringing your fullback right through the ensuing crease. Not real complicated. Quick read. That end goes outside. He's on Dobbs. Teach has the ball, and he's saying, see you later, bye.
16 carries, 148 yards on the ground for Teach. New career high last week, 95 yards. And he is he's on his way to doubling that total. First down, 29-yard line. Teach out. Coming on the edge is Howell. And what a day it's been for Alexander Teach.
Well, from the very beginning, you have to say, look, triple option. So that's fullback, quarterback. Well, you don't ever get to quarterback as option number two if you can't stop that inside run. Because Teach especially, we've seen his quickness. We saw him jam his foot into the ground and be able to make that big cut. Notre Dame just doesn't have two things right now. One is very good integrity as a defense as far as playing assignment football. And number two is speed to match Navy. Because when they get quick on the outside, Notre Dame is chasing.
You got a couple of injured Irishmen down. That was Carlo Calabrese, and that's Ian Williams. Williams getting a hand up. We'll step aside, take a break. 7:34 left, third quarter. Hawaii 5-0 is back, and I think it's Coach Kenny Amatalolo is one of his favorite shows. Quarterback at Hawaii, the left-hander. Well, his quarterback coach was June Jones during his redshirt freshman year, and he coached against June last week, SMU.
Yeah, and that was talk about a little bit of a difference from running any kind of an option style. June Jones comes in with that run and shoot. A long way back, and they've taken two very divergent paths offensively.
Well, you look at Navy, 38 rushes, two passes, and when Ricky Dobbs has passed the ball, it has been very effective. He's under center, second down. Showing blitz, they go right back up the gut to Teach, and he pushes a pile to the 20-yard line.
Market actually back a little closer to the 21, I think. That was a nice job by that interior of the Notre Dame defense. As you see, just as that snap was getting ready to happen, you could read there was going to be a slant and a pinch, and both inside linebackers just came screaming up to meet Ricky Dobbs or the fullback.
Brings up third down, call it a short two. Aaron Santiago, number 26, he scored a 3-yard touchdown last week, checks in. Again, it's Teach all day. Still on his feet. Inside the 10. Move the chains. And Navy is knocking on the door once again. Downstairs we go. Here's Sam Ryan.
Notre Dame. He is on the bench right now, and he's in tears sobbing. It looks like a left leg injury. He's pointing to his left leg. The trainers are wrapping it right now and icing it. But as I mentioned, he is sobbing on the bench, Craig.
All right, thank you, Sam. Teach is having his way, and the Irish, oh boy, Ian Williams. Our best of that big fella, senior, Altamont Springs, Florida. Teach gets the call again and stacked up by Mante Teo.
Yeah, we saw earlier in the game that there were some substitutions in this Notre Dame defense. And then when you saw Calabrese go out, 48 Dan Fox has come in, the sophomore. And they've pretty much concentrated running right at Williams' replacement. And inside, going right at Fox.
Coming up on 5.5 to play in this third quarter. Has been dominated by Navy. Looking for more with a 28-10 lead. Dobbs, second down. Keeper into the pile. Did he make it?
He's in the end zone, I think.
They're going to mark him about a half a yard shy. Did Dobbs attack the line of Notre Dame?
Now watch what he does with the ball. He pulls out, goes in. Now look at him duck under and drive. Oh, that was a very nice call by the officials, because that knee goes down at about the 1.5. The ball is going to be marked right there on about the half yard line. That was a beautiful view right there by our camera guys.
How about Navy? 11 touchdowns in their last 11 red zone possessions. They're looking to add to that. Third down and goal. Keeper Dobbs, the push. No indication. No indication.
Mickey Dobbs is down near the bottom of that pile, and his feet just stopped
touchdown.
Moving.
Touchdown, Navy. He had to peel the layers back to find Dobbs.
Didn't mess around. Got in there behind Brady Demel and Cabral, his guard, and Dowd, his guard. And just right underneath behind him. It isn't the first contact, but his legs just kept going and going. Watch Teach, the fullback, come in there in the back and give him a little power boost, but he's well into the end zone by that point.
Third rushing touchdown for Dobbs. He now ties Chris McCoy for the Navy record with 43 career touchdowns. Rushing touchdowns, and the extra point is up and good. Interceptions, turnovers have really plagued Notre Dame. Navy takes advantage, up big. Looking forward to this game tonight. Both 7-0, LSU and Auburn. Points per game, Auburn 41, 481 yards of total offense, 329 for LSU. I think Auburn, really, Arkansas as well. Those are a couple big surprise teams in the SEC, and now Auburn's right on top the pile at number four.
There are some defensive players in this game that are worth the price of admission, with Nevis and Fairley and Peterson and the rest of them, but I'd pay just to see Cam Newton play just about any time.
How about 10 plays all on the ground for Navy? 73 yards they go, 5 minutes and change off the clock. The Dobbs with his third rushing touchdown of the afternoon, and Navy has blown this game open 35-10.
Chris Colton's the name of the offensive line coach for Navy, and he and his crew have absolutely sliced and diced this Notre Dame defense, especially inside so far.
At the 30, boots away, filling in for Buckley, injured last week. At the 3-yard line goes Bennett Jackson. Has a head of steam, stopped and dropped to the 25. Time now for our Aflac trivia question.
Aflac!
I love that guy. Love him. Hey, Notre Dame's 43 straight wins over Navy is the NCAA's record for most consecutive wins over one opponent. What is the longest active streak?
I don't know, but after Thursday night's tail whipping my UCLA Bruins got from Oregon, I'd almost nominate that as being worth about 40 years worth.
Answer that question a little bit later. 24 minutes of possession time for Navy. On the ground, here comes Armando Allen, has room at the 40 on his feet, runs out of bounds, stops the clock at the 45-yard line with 4:25 to play in the third.
As good as Dane Crist has played at times, he has had these two interceptions, and they have both been clearly balls thrown into areas they shouldn't have been. One there at the end of the half, that was turned into a touchdown. And that interception there was also ultimately put in the end zone the other way.
Rolling out is Crist. Throws in the flat, pitch and catch. Ragone, the tight end. And now Notre Dame trying to get some offense rolling here late in the third quarter. And Randy, sometimes you can dodge the bullet on turnovers, but not today. The two picks have cost the Irish, or pardon me, yes, the Irish 14 points.
Yeah, I mean, you're down at this point by 25 points. And this offense, though, that's four possessions.
Crist in the pocket. Underneath he goes. Oh, pads are popping. And the ball was caught. Nicely done by Duval Kamara. And Max Blue laid the helmet on it. Also up slow is Tyler Simmons. And where is he?
Simmons caught a little head contact.
Oh,
stay right where you are, young man. You don't need to get up.
Hey, let's go, Caleb! Let's go, 5-7!
Now the pads are popped. Blue, Simmons. Simmons had that big fourth quarter pick last week against SMU off Kyle Padrone.
What a beautiful job he did there, just reading Padrone's eyes and getting right into that throwing lane that Padrone was trying to fit that ball in. That's a scary moment. Anytime you see a football player not only hesitate on the ground like that, but try to get up and wobble. Tell you what, I'd steal his helmet right now.
Yeah.
Wouldn't let him back in the ballgame.
I think he's doing a good fake job right now. How are you? I'm fine. What day is it? I think it's Tuesday.
Take his helmet. He doesn't need to play anymore after doing that.
Crist, shotgun. Hand it off right up the middle goes Allen. And to the 31, he'll be marked as Hallberger made the tackle. Outside linebacker out of Baltimore. He's got a big family on hand. You know, Notre Dame's got some New Jersey connections. Kamara out of Jersey City. I think tickets were at a premium for this one. Crist in the pocket. Underneath. John Goodman. Taken down by the shirt tail at the 26.
What a great experience for these two football teams to play in this venue. I know Notre Dame's pretty used to playing in different spots. Last year in Jerry Jones's palace down in Dallas. And you know, they do get around a little, but this place is really something special here in the Meadowlands. And Navy's done a great job of outfitting it as their home field.
Pushing hard, Armando Allen. And a wave of midshipmen in on that tackle to the 24-yard line. So they move the chains, fresh downs. First and 10, Irish.
So you're encouraged if you're Notre Dame. You're moving the ball, you're being effective. You're controlling it, not doing anything dumb with the ball, but you have to have a sense of urgency. You've got to score because your defense hasn't gotten the other offense off the field.
Two wide receivers, top of your screen. Oh, the pass just knocked away off the hands of Ragone, and it was Max Blue hanging on his shirt.
Yeah, Blue had the wraparound working as the ball arrived, denying Ragone the ability to get those arms up and catch that pass. Another tight fit by Dane Crist. That ball was right there off of Blue's backside.
Eighth play of the drive, second down 10, 24-yard line. Crist, good protection again underneath, and you got to catch the ball. T.J. Jones turned his head. I think you'll see it on the replay. He was looking, and there was a lot of room to run.
Yeah, Jones had come from that near slot position. He didn't get that man up coverage again like he had the one time on McCauley where he got the touchdown. He came underneath on a drag. Crist gave him a nice little soft toss. He took his eyes off it trying to sneak a peek up field to see what was coming.
Jones, a freshman, Gainesville, Georgia. Crist again wants to throw in the pocket pressure. That ball may have been tipped from behind. There was pressure on the edge.
It was Tuani that reached in there and got a piece of Dane Crist's arm. Coming up from that defensive line position at the top of your screen, Jabari Tuani.
Right
trying
there
to push him wide, but he just gets the wrist.
Got the wrist, kept the helmet on. Last week lost the hat against SMU. And now fourth down. 10. Crisp in the pocket. Flush, and down it goes. No one. No one open. Covered sack.
And it was a coverage sack, but Navy defensively is bringing four pass rushers. And Tuani again coming inside off of the offensive guard, just is able to push and push right back into the backfield. Tell you, Trevor Robinson got walked back into Chris' lap.
That's the dance. Kenny Amatalolo, everything going Navy's direction in this one thus far against Notre Dame. And Teach breaks a tackle, takes a stutter step, 45-yard line. We go to New York for an update. Here's Tim.
All right, Craig, this may be attrition Saturday for unbeatens. We began with 10. We'll soon see, right? Dan Persa, his third touchdown rushing of the day, and it's 24-14. Safe to say Michigan State is being persecuted this afternoon. Back to you.
Oh, Tim. Yes, very good. Very good.
That works for you, Timmy B.
Well, Teach is teaching Notre Dame a lesson. I see a few Irish fans beginning to make their way out of New Meadowlands Stadium as we roll up on a minute to play here in the third. Maybe a busted player. Dobbs wanted to give that ball away. Well, tomorrow on 60 Minutes, how did a TV show about guys and cars and laughs become one of the most popular shows on the planet? You'll find out tomorrow, only on 60 Minutes, right here on CBS.
Hey, what, following us this afternoon, that LSU-Auburn game, that is going to be something else, because they're going to have a little bit of everything. Got some real nice defense from LSU.
Yes.
That Auburn offense, if you hadn't had a chance to see it, get a bag of chips and a couple of soft drinks and kick back and relax. Enjoy that one.
Dobbs. So about the 49 of Notre Dame, Darius Fleming with the tackle. And we're winding it down here in the third quarter. Randy, I wonder if Les Miles has more magic in his back pocket. He has pulled out a couple of magical wins this year.
It isn't a fluke if you keep doing it all the time, and he's done it for the better part of his career no matter where he's been.
Chris is on the phone, and a big fourth quarter needed for Notre Dame. Navy 35, the Irish 10, and we'll return to the new Meadowlands Stadium right after this message and a word from your local station. Start the fourth quarter, Navy in control, 35-10. Craig Bullard, Jack, Randy Cross, Sam Ryan, our CBS crew here at the new Meadowlands Stadium. Randy, I don't think you and I, anyone expected this type of ball game, the way Navy has dominated, especially on the ground, and the way Notre Dame has been playing defensively against the rush of late.
Yeah, after, you know, two games in a row or three games where they've held their opponents to a total of 150, Brian Kelly's defense has given up over 300 yards rushing here in three quarters.
Still 15 minutes on the clock. Teach has had his way all afternoon against the Irish in that Navy backfield. He'll get the carry once again. Spins up to around the 45-yard line. He'll be a yard shy of the first down.
Yeah, bears mentioning again, Craig. You said at the very beginning of this game in the open about 43 years straight Notre Dame beat Navy. But this class of Navy football player knows nothing but competing with Notre Dame. They're proving it to Notre Dame right now.
They have won two out of the last three, including last year in South Bend.
Trying to draw Notre Dame's defense off.
Fourth and short. Now Dobbs takes a glance.
10 seconds left on the play clock. Plenty of time.
Down to 8. Down to 6. Down to 4. Down to 3. And timeout.
First time out of the half.
So Navy will burn their first time out of the second half as they look at fourth and about a yard at the 45-yard line.
Yeah, that was solely designed just in the chance with all that quick motion by the S-backs of just pulling the defense offside.
Well, tomorrow the Amazing Race teams live on the edge as they experience new highs, new lows, and everything in between. A new Amazing Race after 60 minutes tomorrow right here on CBS. Let's team up and do that. What do you say?
Have you seen some of the stuff they have to do?
I don't know. If I
I don't bungee and cord drop real well. Gravity's not my friend.
You know, I think about that. That does worry me a little bit there, Mr. Cross.
Because you'd be on the other end of the rope.
That is a troublesome thought. Della Hook is going to punt. And Goodman is set to return. This will be only the second punt of the day for Navy. And what a pooch kick it was last time Della Hook put a foot on it. High hanger. Got a chance for catch at the five. Okay, all facets of the game in high gear for Navy. 14:07 to play. We'll be back.
And now it's time for our Geico game recap.
Well, after stopping Notre Dame at the 1 yard line, Alexander Cheech goes 34 yards. A pass from Dobbs will go up 7-0 in the opening quarter. And then Notre Dame answers with a field goal of 45 yards from Ruffner, 7-3. Second quarter, Dobbs, 3 yard touchdown, 14-3 Navy. Irish answer, the freshman TJ Jones from Frisk, a 16 yard connection, 14-10. Then GG Green goes around the edge to stiff arm 9 yards at 21-10. Now we go third quarter, Dobbs. 9 yard run and everything going right. 28-10 Navy. Then after an interception, Dobbs again plunges 1 yard, and that's where we stand, 35-10 with 14 minutes to play in this ball game. Notre Dame at their own 6 yard line, five wide receivers set, and they spread it wide. Chris from his end zone throws underneath, pitch and catch. It's Sierra Wood still on his feet. First down and then some at the 16-17 yard line. Aaron McCauley with the tackle.
So one thing, Notre Dame has not struggled moving the ball. They did that from the very beginning, going almost the length of the field.
Again, five wide outs on the rollout. There's a little sliding catch by Eifert, the tight end. We've seen Ragone and now Eifert.
The problem really Notre Dame has gotten into, besides the fact that they've thrown a few interceptions, is that they've had some opportunities, and it's either been an inaccurately thrown ball or just flat dropped.
Tied up was Goodman as he tried to hit a slant across the middle of the field.
And it's part of the growing process, I really think, of Brian Kelly and what he wants to bring here offensively to Notre Dame. We talk about the fast pace. Yeah, I think he also wants to have a little bit smaller linemen so he can play at that fast pace. And quicker, more speed on the outside from receivers.
Third down. Chris. Oh, the pads are popping again. Kamara with the reception, but well short of the first down. That brings up fourth now for the Irish.
Well, the first on the hit on Kamara was blue. The second on the hit is Middleton. Blue just T-bones him and holds him up, and Middleton just lights his world.
So a quick series for the Irish. Ben Turk is set to punt inside his own 10-yard line. Gary Myers is set to return. A line drive short, takes a Notre Dame bounce, and Myers covers up at the 34. Timeout, 12:45. Down the stretch we go. Navy by 25. The Home Depot College Football on CBS is sponsored by Red Lobster, Privosec OTC, Coke Zero, and by Cadillac. 35-10 Navy on top of the Irish of Notre Dame, and Notre Dame's 43 straight wins over Navy is the NCAA record for most consecutive wins over one opponent. What is the longest active streak? Well, we've got the Aflac answer. Penn State, 28 straight over Temple. 28 in a row.
Just imagine if they played them every year.
Joe Paul's had his way. Navy back at it at the 34-yard line. After the punt, Dobbs, terrific job. And he pitches outside right on the money. G.G. Green slides past the 35 to the 36. Brian Smith, the outside backer with the tackle for the Irish. Well, who else? How about, okay, the 28 against Temple. Tennessee over Kentucky, 25 in a row. A&M over TCU. 24 straight, and Florida's had their way with Kentucky. Now the Irish, I think those faces kind of tell the story. A bit stunned. I think we are. Right? I did not expect this type of dominance by Navy's offense.
Judging by the last couple of years, you'd say, hey, Navy can hang with Notre Dame. Might not flat whip them.
Well, upended at the 40.
And really what's happened is up front for Navy, that offensive line has done a very nice job. You know, Battipaglia has come in there at that left tackle and nailed that down. Having a guy like DeMel inside at center has really helped. Bassford's over at right tackle. And as a group, I tell you what, they have really inside taken apart Notre Dame. And that set up the quick flip to G.G. Green. That set up Ricky Dobbs after the first option has been expired.
Third down and four. Dobbs pitch nicely covered, but then the tackle can't be made. Secondary help. It'll be fourth down. To New York we go. Here's Tim.
Craig, Randy, this is one you didn't probably see coming. Texas, after their win against Nebraska, getting pounded now by Iowa State at home. Austin Arnott to Josh Lynch. Beautiful catch. It was in for the score. 21-6 early in the fourth quarter. Back to you.
Timmy B, I know Bo Pelini in Nebraska would like to have played that version of Texas rather than the one they caught.
You know, it's amazing week to week how these things happen in college football. But, Randy, it's the cliches of cliches. That's why you play them.
Oh, absolutely. And so much of the college game is about emotion and how mentally prepared you are to actually play on that given day.
They'll hook the punt. And a squibber takes a midshipman bounce. It is spinning and stops at the 24. And it is time for the cross-examination.
Well, I didn't even know they had color film back then.
Oh, we had to go down.
Great week in college football, though. The first BCS poll this week. Just relax, folks. Don't get too excited. There's a whole bunch of these coming. The whole idea is to get you to think about it. Realignment, big part of the offseason last year. And I don't think they're done yet, personally. And the one that really gets me is this agent and money. A lot of that going on. Keep an eye out for more of that. And playoffs? I don't know. Are you a playoff guy, Craig?
You know what? I think it's time.
Really?
I do.
I think you only survive. You only identify a survivor in football, not the best team. Well, it looked like a face mask on wood there.
New quarterback for the Irish. Number 13, and I've got him as Tommy Rees.
It is. It's Tommy Rees. He's the thrower. Nate Montana, the other backup quarterback. Joe Montana's son, more of a runner in this offense. So Rees obviously in there to throw the ball a lot more.
From the shotgun, stands in the pocket with a cold arm, flips it and connects, and the ball is taken by Toma. And a first down, Irish at the 39-yard line. So Christ with a rough day, to say the least. A couple of picks turned into touchdowns by Navy.
Well, you're playing a defense that not only has made you turn the ball over, they have made you go multiple plays, dozen plays or so if you're going to score. And then when they've gotten the chance of getting the ball in the red zone, they score touchdowns.
Rees throws, sets and fires. Up top goes Sierra Wood. Wood still on his feet, breaks a tackle, throws out a forearm, and is bucked out of bounds past the 40 to the 37-yard line. Devon Richardson with the stop. Now Irish still fighting away, down 25, clock rolling up on 9 minutes to play. Shotgun, pressure from the edge, up over the top, wide open is Eifert. And the Irish knocking on the door at the 15-yard line. Richardson again on the stop. Now, is this because of a change of quarterback or a softer defense?
I don't know if it's a softer defense. You can feel a little bit less spit and fire in the Navy side, a little bit more aggression, a little bit more emotion on the Notre Dame side. Could be just as simple as that.
Under 9 minutes to play. Reese has come in relief of Christ. Instant offense. Navy brings a blitzer from the corner into the end zone and complete. Toma, the intended receiver.
Navy decided to mix it up a little bit. They brought a pretty good all-out blitz attacking Reese. Notre Dame did a good job of cutting down the blitz and giving Reese some time to throw.
Take a look at the Horizon red zone. At the 15-yard line, second down, Notre Dame. Reese throws, coming back to the ball is Kamara. And Notre Dame is threatening to find the end zone. Short of the first down.
You think back, and if you watch Cincinnati last year when Brian Kelly was there, and some of the athletes that he had on that football team, when you flip the ball out like that, there was a chance it was going the distance. He just right now does not have the same kind of people to run this offense.
And he told us it would take time.
Does that exist at Notre Dame?
No. Very little. Oh, catch pulled down. Eifert still on his feet after the initial hit. And then pushed back around the 9-8-yard line. Hallberger and company with the tackle. Now get back to Brian Kelly for a moment. Replaces Charlie Weiss. You know, he had three great years at Cincinnati. I mean, 34-6. He went to the Orange. He went to the Sugar. He was a three-time Big East Coach of the Year. He had great success in Division II at Grand Valley, a two-time Division II title winner. Can he turn the Irish around? Fourth down. Crowds up. Reese throws. And the drive continues. Inside the 5-yard line, Robbie Toma, the sophomore, went up high on the ladder. And it's first and goal for the Irish.
Sometimes the holes in a defense are not close to the ground. Tommy Reese did a very nice job of standing in, just striding through that one.
The fresh downs, first and goal, 3-yard line. Reese has led this drive to the one. Handoff goes to Wood. Tawani with the tackle.
Notre Dame's been down here before.
Yes. And first, Navy took it back the other way 99 yards.
Yeah, first drive of the game, they got down in the same general area with the same confidence and the same ease in the drive.
Sierra Wood lines up behind Reese on second and goal. Wood in, touchdown, Notre Dame. Wood rumbles in for his second rushing touchdown of the season.
Take a look at left guard Stewart come around. Watch the job he does. Think this would be kind of an easy run? Just a pancake on King. It's easy to follow those 350-pound pulling guards.
Ruffner will try the point after. High snap, good hold, kick is away, and up she goes. A long drought by the Irish. Wood from 1 yard out. 35-17 Navy. Sierra Wood finds the end zone. Notre Dame, 10 plays, 76 yards, 4 minutes off the clock.
Big Stewart, number 59, right there at left guard, just come around and smash. He may be in law school trying to be a counselor, but for right now, he still gets to be a crusher. Coming right off Eifert's block and pancaking.
Yes, he sure did. Stewart, the big fella, 6'5", 351. He's our Red Lobster scholar athlete, a 3'5", as you mentioned. He's in law school, and Red Lobster's commitment to the investment of our future is shown today by donating $1,000 to the Notre Dame General Scholarship Fund. Way to go, big fella.
Oh, kid. And if that sounds unusual, you're absolutely right. That's the only young man in FBS football attending law school while they're playing football. That's a bit of a class load.
What a day that is. Irish kick it away. Marcus Thomas. Did he take a shot at the 25-yard line? Let's check in with Sam.
Oh, Craig and Randy, Brian Kelly still settling in his first year as Irish head coach. Now, he told us the thing that surprised him the most about taking the position is the schedule, and it is an intense schedule. If you take a look at what a typical Friday looks like for Brian Kelly, it includes meeting with team donors, a TV production meeting, a Friday luncheon with about 1,000 guests, team meetings, and, yeah, there is some time for football in there, but busy to say the least, guys.
Yes, football at the team hotel, Sam, 7:15. That's a full day.
And it was about 5 or 6 hours before that first 10:30 meeting with the donor, too.
Dobbs went to hand it off. Nobody there. Put it in the belly and picked up maybe a yard to the 28-yard line. What a day for Dobbs and Teach in that Navy backfield.
Yeah, this you've gotten to see, if you've seen this game from beginning to end, you've watched a triple option offense frustrate,
hey, Pop,
get
hey, Pop.
After, but more than anything else, just sort of befuddle a college team that does not see this style of offense very often, and it looked like it.
Quick hitter to the fullback, Teach. Anti Teo, terrific afternoon, trying to plug the holes for Notre Dame. You know, this game, Randy, is what most people expected at the beginning of the year, that lost that opener to Maryland with multiple turnovers. But today, everything's rolling right along. Teach is flirting with a 200-yard ground game.
Yeah, he is. And Ricky Dobbs, look at the stats, 71 passing, 80 rushing, 3 touchdowns. That's the kind of game that was pretty standard Ricky Dobbs stuff last year in 2009.
Third down and 3. Dobbs on the keeper, close to a first down, and let's go to Tim Brando for this Heisman watch presented by Nissan.
All right, Craig, well, Michael James continued his path towards the Heisman, reeling off 123 yards on 20 carries, 3 touchdowns on Thursday night in Oregon's romp over UCLA. But coming up next, arguably the front runner, Cam Newton, who only needs 147 yards to become the SEC's record holder for rushing yards by a quarterback in a season, and Patrick Peterson, the most electrifying defensive player in the country for LSU. That's coming up next on CBS. Back to you.
And there's a good matchup. Gary Danielson, Timmy Beatty, brought up a great point during the week that it wouldn't be a bad idea to maybe put Peterson on Cam Newton.
Let them decide it against one another.
Yeah.
Yeah, Newton has really come up the ranks, the ladder of the Heisman hopefuls. Ricky Dobbs was on that list early this season, but injury took him off.
There's a guy you don't hear much about, Kellen Moore at Boise State. All he's done is had 16 touchdowns, 1 interception. Leading one of the top-ranked football teams and one of the best offenses you're ever going to see at Boise.
Boise State, TCU, Utah, all just under the radar, just kind of flying around, waiting to see how it all works out.
Right over.
Under 4 minutes to play. And now a timeout as that play clock ran it down to 1. Kenny Amatalolo right on the spot to get the timeout, and we'll step aside. 3:29 to play.
Cam Newton, the quarterback for the Auburn Tigers, number one rusher in the SEC with 860 yards and 12 rushing touchdowns, has also had a very effective year under Gus Malzahn's offense there at Auburn, and all those touchdowns rushing, 6'6", 240, and fast.
And, of course, that game follows here on CBS, SEC Country, LSU Auburn, number 6 against number 4. That game will rattle up the top 10, won't it?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely, and maybe put to rest either how good is Auburn or giving LSU and Les Miles a little more credit than everybody has been giving them the last month or so instead of giving them so much grief.
35-17, 3:29 to play. You see the timeouts. One remaining for the midshipmen, the Irish with three. But right now the clock is being chewed off. And you talk about chewing turf. Alexander Teach, over 200 yards rushing. What a ball game. What a day for this young man.
Yeah, how about in the big team huddle that happened during that timeout? He was right smack dab in the middle, screaming and yelling, exhorting his offensive line. First fullback in Navy history to have over 200 yards rushing.
You know, he just comes off the field, he's shaking the dust out of his helmet. You know, I think he was, I don't think he wanted to come out. I'm not sure if he's going to see the light of day after this. But we'll see. Under 3 minutes, third down and short. Dobbs cuts it up. First down and more, and continues to push to the 45, 46 yard line. Zeke Mata, one of the safeties, in on the tackle. It has been all Navy, all day on the ground. Two and a half to play.
And the runs we've seen here in this drive has just sort of been a encapsulation of what we've seen the entire game. A lot of good blocking up front, giving you that fullback hit. And when they swallow and bite on the fullback, Ricky Dobbs taking the follow.
On a move is G.G. Green. Monday on CBS, how do you solve a murder when an old flame becomes the prime suspect? See why Hawaii 5-0 is TV's number one news show. Monday only right here on CBS.
Old, new, or current, there isn't a better theme song of any show going.
You know, when you hear that, it just takes you back.
I always see in my mind's eye that big curling blue wave.
Book 'em.
Dano looks a little different now, though.
It sure does. Into the pile goes Teach. No, he's not done for the day. And the clock moves on under a minute 30. Substitutions now for Navy as Kendi Amatalolo has an opportunity to have some players get some time. And here comes Teach, I believe, off the field for the last time. How about that hug? He got a nice handshake and hug from his head coach.
Right now, this Navy football team has run for somewhere in the mid-300s against a Notre Dame team that had allowed half of that, or less than half of that, in the last three games combined.
Diggs, who backs up Teach, gets the carry and move the chains to the 34-yard line. And those fans who remain stand and applaud the effort, Randy Cross, given by the midshipmen this afternoon. And Navy, this Navy senior class will soon join the classes of 1937, 1964 as the only class, only classes to beat Notre Dame three times in their career. And this also will be the first win on a neutral site for Navy against the Irish since 1960 in Philadelphia.
Wow. And there was nothing overtime, nothing last minute. Nothing fluky about this. This was soup to nuts. They just whipped the backside of Notre Dame inside and out.
And Randy, I really think that the statement was made to start the third quarter. We talked to Brian Kelly. They said, yeah, we've made some adjustments, but Navy came out with the football and scored.
Well, they made adjustments, and it seemed like Kendi Amatalolo's guys adjusted back a little bit, but they never solved the physical conundrum. The main problem was physically they were getting blocked and they never figured out a way to get unblocked.
Navy now with three consecutive wins over Wake Forest, SMU, and Notre Dame. Their record stands at 5-2. The Irish, their three-game winning streak comes to an end, and their season record now at 4-4. They had beaten BC, Pitt, and last week Western Michigan. But they run up against a potent ground attack this afternoon. Navy. Alexander Teach over 200 yards from his fullback position. And now a special moment. Ricky Dobbs leads Navy over Notre Dame, 35-17. Randy Cross, 367 yards on the ground, over six yards a carry for the midshipman.
Yeah, it was as good as this football time has its football team has looked at any time in 2010. Easy.
Notre Dame makes a turn, heads of the tunnel. On a disappointing afternoon on the defensive end of the ball, Randy made the point that the Irish had been so potent defensively against the run of late. In fact, the last three games, they've allowed just less than 2 yards a carry. Today, they gave up over six. Let's check down downstairs, and here's Sam.
Coach Nehemiah.